Hey guys, welcome back to my kitchen. In today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make pasta carbonara. Now, this is probably one of Rome's most famous dishes. They're actually known for four different pastas, but pasta carbonara across the board is probably the most popular. Another popular dish that's similar to that is called cacio e pepe, which is basically like cheese and pepper. But they're similar in their cooking technique in which that they both use pasta water to create the sauce. Now, several months back, almost a year ago, my family and I, we took a trip to the Mediterranean and we went to several different places in Italy and the Greek Isles, but we started and ended our vacation in Rome and we spent several days there. And every day we'd go out, during lunchtime, you would see in all the outdoor cafes, all the businessmen and women, as well as workers, all different social classes eating not only pasta for lunch, but pasta carbonara and cacio e pepe. So they're not only famous for this dish, they're actually eating it. Romans are eating it every single day. Now in today's tutorial, I'm gonna be using an extra thick pasta called bucatini. If you can't find it or you're not really into thick spaghetti, don't worry about it. You can just use regular thick spaghetti or at the very least just regular spaghetti. Also traditionally, pasta carbonara is made with guanciale. Guanciale is pork jowl. It's a cured meat and it's not impossible to find here, but I wouldn't walk into my local supermarket and expect to see it sitting there on the shelf, right? But what you can get, what is readily available is pancetta, and that is comparable to guanciale. So, enough talking. Let's get cooking.
We'll start by first bringing a large pot of water up to a boil. Here I have some salt. We'll add 2 to 3 tablespoons of salt to the water. So while we're waiting for the water to come up to a boil, let's cook off our pancetta. Here I have pre-diced pancetta. We're gonna start in a cold pan. I have 2 packages, they're 4 ounces each, so it's a total of 8 ounces. We're gonna turn on the heat and start rendering out the fat slowly. So here you can see the pancetta has come up to temperature and the fat is starting to render out. Oh, and I forgot to mention, I'm cooking the pancetta on medium-high heat. After several minutes, the pancetta is pretty much cooked down. We're going to shut off the heat. And now I'm just going to push the pancetta to one side of the pan because we're going to remove most of the grease from the pancetta, but reserve at least 3 tablespoons at the bottom of the pan for the pasta. Okay, so we'll just set this to the side and then we'll begin cooking our pasta and preparing our egg and cheese mixture. So our water is now boiling. Let's add the bucatini. We're gonna cook the bucatini until it's al dente. Just check the directions on your pasta package. It'll tell you how long to cook your pasta, whether you're using bucatini or thick spaghetti. So I've added 16 ounces of the pasta and now I'm stirring it to make sure it doesn't stick. So while the pasta is cooking, let's start our egg and cheese mixture. Here I have Parmesan cheese and I'm gonna grate 1/2 cup. That's 1/2 cup. So just throw that in the bowl. And now we're going to grate some Pecorino Romano. And we're gonna do 1/4 cup of that. And now we'll just add that to the Parmesan cheese. Here, I'm freshly grinding black peppercorn. You need approximately 1 teaspoon. And we're gonna add that to the cheese mixture. And then next, we'll add our eggs. You need 1 whole egg, so we'll do that one first. And of course, my shells just don't wanna break. And next, 3 egg yolks. So in a separate bowl, I'm gonna put the white part of the egg. And you can do this, you can use the shell and pass the yolk back and forth, allowing the egg white to drop into one bowl, and then you could add your yolk to the cheese mixture. Or you could do it like this, a lot quicker and easier, just put it in your hand and squeeze off the egg white, and then add the yolk to your cheese mixture. And that's the final egg yolk. And you can save your whites for like an omelet. Now just combine the eggs, cheese, and pepper until it's smooth, and then it's done. Let's go check on our pasta. Okay, so I've turned the heat back on to the pancetta to just bring it up to heat. Now let's see if our pasta is cooked. So we'll test one strand. We're good to go. So shut the heat off the pancetta. You do not want the heat on anymore. And now you're gonna start to add the pasta from the water directly into the pan with the pancetta. And then just give it a really good stir. And now you need 1 cup of pasta water. If you want your sauce to be thinner, you can certainly add a little bit more water. I like mine thicker, so I'm doing 1 cup. All right, so now we're gonna add our egg and cheese mixture, place it in, and then just begin to quickly stir nonstop the pasta, egg, and cheese mixture with the pasta water and pancetta. And you'll see it'll start to create a creamy sauce. Again, no heat on, you don't want to scramble your eggs. But look at that, a beautiful creamy sauce. So it's done, now let's plate it and taste it.
All right, here it is guys, our pasta carbonara. And I put a little extra grated cheese and black pepper on mine. Now it's time to taste. That yummy, crispy, slightly salty pork with that rich egg and cheese coating the pasta. It's absolutely fabulous. I love it. And I suggest you drink some beer to go with your carbonara. Beer will cut through the heaviness, the richness of the sauce. And I'm gonna have a Peroni, which is an Italian beer. Salud. That is wonderful. Well, I'm gonna leave you with a little lingo that you can drop when you wanna call the family to dinner. And that is, tutti a tavola a mangiare, which is everyone to the table to eat. Well, I hope you guys try and enjoy this recipe. Please, give me a thumbs up if you like this video. Don't forget, subscribe to my channel so you don't miss out on anything. And as always guys, until next time, ciao!